up? Marty Schwartz here. Beginners, stay tuned. Gonna teach that coming right up. But this way is not that hard either. You should check it out. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Cape on the first fret, and then I'm gonna play an E major chord. Just like that. Then I'm gonna take this little piece, these two fingers, and just scoot it over a string. And that's called an A sus 2. And we play that. And it sounds really cool. Listen to that. So we have that's easy guitar playing. Don't get mad at me though if you're a beginner. Everyone put their time in. So what I'm saying is this is a good thing to practice. Okay, then we're gonna hit that one again. Back to E. So check it out. So this third chord is what makes it a little bit harder. It's a B sus 4 is what we would call it. But basically we take our first finger and put it on the second fret, you know, if the capo was 0, so 1, 2. Then ring finger, so it's actually kind of like a, what I've taught as a power chord. Like that. But then get your pinky in there. And then you can let, you don't have to bar anything, you can let those two things ring out right there, check it out. Oh yeah, it's all shimmery. Okay, so. So if it's really hard to get to that third chord right there, if you look at the way my fingers are positioned, when people first start playing guitar, their hands are kind of back like that a lot, and they're having to reach really far. But if you can start getting a little more use, look at my hand like this, like that. If you can get, when you're playing guitar, just get your hand a little more like that, see where my fingers are kind of lined up parallel with the frets, do you see that? That's kind of a proper technique thing, so. In other words, if your pinky's gonna need to go somewhere, you know, it's probably not a good idea to be playing a chord with it out there and then to reach it in. So then you can go like this. Down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down. Okay, on to the super easy way, and capo on the third fret, and then we play just a standard D major chord. And then we go to a G chord, where the ring finger's down and the pinky, like that, so. Then G back to D, and this happens all the time in music, so you want to practice that anyway. What better way to practice this than within a familiar sounding chord progression. Ding, ding. Just like that. Rest, rest. Then we're gonna go to an A major chord with the pinky down right there. I think that's the best way to think of it. Because if you just went to a straight A chord, you're gonna be all right, but if you have that down, it's even more matching up with the other guitar part, so. And so if you're a super beginner and you're still trying to learn those chords, what I recommend is, I've said it before, but think of one finger as the starting point of the chord. And it's going to be typically the finger that's the highest up here. So with the D chord, if I'm trying to remember, I don't even know the shape yet, think of first finger on the second fret of the G string right there. Boom, D chord. Okay, what else goes? G chord, middle finger on the third fret. Boom. Okay, that kind of thing. An A chord, first finger right there, second fret of the D string.